We barely have two nickels to rub together. Now we're paying for all that food. Jesus Christ!
Watch that mouth of yours.
We wouldn't be in this mess if you would have listened to me.
What mess?
It's not something you need to worry about, Lincoln. I got it under control.
Under control? God damn it, you need
to... Boy, I'm not warning you again!
Have it your way, old man!
Let him be. He needs to cool off.
You mind telling me what's got him so riled up?
We've been having problems with the Haitians. But like I say, I got it under control.
Well, truck's all loaded up. I figure we got enough out there for... Should I come back?
In honor of your returning to us safe and sound, I made a donation to Father James here. Supplied him with food he can hand out to some of our needier family.
Well, I was hoping you'd lend me a hand, Lincoln, and give you a chance to see the neighborhood.
This thing with the Haitians, how serious is it?
Ah, you know Ellis. Someone looks at him the wrong way, he's on them like a wet dog.
Like I said, I can come back.
Nonsense. Lincoln needs to get out. Enjoy the day. Besides, be good for the two of you to spend some time together. Go on. Those people waiting on their food.
Oh, I saw Langan a couple times once he was first back. He told me he wanted to leave town, head out to California. Now, he had a friend in the service who could get him a job working at the Mare Island shipyard. And the only reason he came back was to tell Sammy and Ellis goodbye. But then he found out about the trouble Sammy was having with those Haitians. So he decided to stay and help. Those Haitians, they are bad news. No talking Lincoln out of it. Whatever else he might have become, Lincoln was always loyal.
Welding, most likely. 3-month apprenticeship to start, then the union lets you in.
You tell Sammy and Ellis?
Not yet. Gonna wait a few days. Didn't want to spring it on them since I just got back.
Well, they won't like to hear it, but they'll come around. You need to do what's best for you. Go ahead and start serving those folks. I'll be back.
Give Sammy my best, Lincoln.
Yes, sir.
Warm meal, warm heart. Full shot. Thanks.
Hello? You delivering a real blessing here, Lincoln. Thank you.
Blessing's mine, ma'am.
Couple days back and they already got you working?
I'm happy to do it.
Means a hell of a lot to all of us.
Don't get old, son. It's a fucking shit show.
I'll see what I can do about that.
Hey there, Lincoln.
How are you, Regine?
I'm good. Nice to see you around the holler again.
Nice to see those big brown eyes again.
Well, they'll be over at my aunt's place with the rest of me. You should stop by.
Maybe I'll do that.
Lincoln, we got trouble.
Run, Regine!
We have seen
you.
Yes,
we're done with you, Lincoln. Sammy's next.
Just had to stop.
Don't take a body!
Shoot him!
You boys ought to be ashamed!
Francois Papadoc Duvalier
and was elected president of Haiti in 1957. By 1959, he had created a secret police called Tonton Macoute, and people started to flee. Most of them settled in the southern United States. Now, mixed in with the good, hard-working people were hardened criminals. They formed the backbone of what became the Haitian gang. Now, Lincoln found out they set up in the swamps and were led by a man named Baca.
You and Father James done already?
We got jumped by the Haitians. It's time you level with me. Tell me what's really going on.
Yes. I suppose it is. Six, 7 months ago, folks in the hollow started getting robbed. Money, jewelry, things of that nature. Didn't take long for us to figure out it was the Haitians. Then those bêtes on velours started going after the lottery.
How much money are we talking about? How much?
Enough that we're in deep shit with Sal Marcano. Haven't kicked up to him in 3 months.
Jesus Christ. If I deal with them, that gives us time to settle up with Marcano, right?
Let me worry about Sal. He and I go way back. But this thing with the Haitians, it's time for it to end. You and Ellis need to handle it.
How are we gonna find them?
Back in the 20s, folks used to pull salt out of the bayou. They built themselves a little shanty town. When the Depression hit, they abandoned it. That's the only place this could have come from.
We're gonna need guns and ammo.
Call this number. But do it away from here. No sense tipping anybody off.
Or we could sweep the hollow, track down and kill every last one of those cocksuckers, then we wouldn't have to worry about it.
The last thing folks in this neighborhood need to see is colored people killing each other. Do this quiet, away from here.
Once we eliminate whoever's running the show, the rest of them will go down on their own. Trust me.
All right, soldier boy. I'll follow your lead.
Be careful, yeah? Those Haitians are a hard people. Do not ever underestimate them. Celui qui sait diverser sait suscite hostilité.
You sure this is how you want to play this?
Last thing they're gonna expect is an attack from the water. You head back round to the row. Stay with the car. I'll meet you over there when this is done.
Hope you know what you're doing.
Trust me, Ellis. Here in a bit, this'll all be behind us.
They hit the bar. The other's going after Pearl. Boss says if we have to burn down half the hollow to get Sammy, we doing it. Ain't stopping to
Papa Legba, open the gate.
And the other one.
Lincoln Clay.
He's the one. This time he won't get away from us. Should've killed that old man a long time ago.
Huh? Think the boss was worried Sammy didn't involve Marcano. Ask him to come down on us.
Petit pour maman, fais dodo, petit pour maman, si bébé parfait dodo, grand loulou va manger, grand loulou va manger, si bébé parfait dodo, grand loulou va manger.
On Sammy's boy. Wouldn't have been bad if they got the motherfucker.
Another one down!
Jesus H!
He really coming over here?
Jesus H! Christ!
African blood.
Fuck you!
However moved.
Should've killed me when you had the chance, asshole!
First, I...
Fuck you! Who won, Bata? Fuck you!
You made a big mistake going after the Hollow. That's why he's your Zeke. Coward! That's why it's all. Fuck me. Not on such a white man.
The man you're talking about took me in when I had nowhere else to go.
You are no better than him. You can't take those stones! You fucking pig! Damn you to hell!
Take it easy!
Take it easy! Take it easy! He kept me in there, locked in there, day and night. Beat me, use me! I kissed you, motherfucker! You and your entire goddamn family!
He's dead! He's dead! He can't hurt you anymore. It's over.
Over? Over? This is never going to be over. Pajam!
Fucking Haitians.
I just thought something. Sammy's boy is in there. Kill him!
He's gone.
You can find his
we ain't stopping till we find you, bruh!
Hey,
Everybody get behind me.
Until we find you.
Stop until we find you, bro.
Don't let me die like this.
Watch out!
Grab him, come on.
Shoot him from the side!
Time.
Always gotta get you out of trouble, don't I?
You home?
I am. How'd it go with Baca?
Well, we came to an understanding. He stayed dead, and I'd let him. Let's get back to Sammy's.
Can't even tell you how happy Pops is gonna be. And this shit with the Haitians has been weighing on him.
With them out the way, things will calm down. We're back to the way.
Fuck it, it's your car. Bash it up all you want.
Anyway, as I was saying, with them out the way, things will calm down. We're back to the way they should be.
Been telling him for months we needed to do something like this, but Pops, I don't know. Sometimes I think he's lost the taste for this shit.
Just because a man don't rush to violence don't mean he lost something.
I know, just makes me wonder what happens after, you know?
No, I don't know. Explain it to me.
Don't matter if it's a bullet or the hand of God. We all go sometime, right?
I suppose. But Ellis, we don't need to talk about...
I pray that Pops outlives the both of us. But if he doesn't, every motherfucker in the Hollow's gonna be looking to us or gunning for us. Just saying we gotta be ready when that day comes.
Yeah, well, that's not something we gotta worry about right now. So just cool it with your grand plans, all right?
Yeah, all right.
Fang Lincoln didn't understand, or maybe want to understand, is that for a man like Sammy, there's always gonna be more Haitians. Now, if there wasn't someone going after Sammy, then there was someone else forcing him into a bad situation. It was never going in. That's how Mankin ended up working for Sal Marcano.
You were right about those Haitians being down by that old salt mine. They won't be bothering us again.
It was a mistake sending you down there. I should handle my own business.
This isn't any different than what I was doing before I left.
You probably don't know this. But every night, on the TV, right after the news, they show the names of all the boys killed over there in Vietnam. I'd be sitting in the kitchen eating my supper, watching that list scroll by, wondering if today is the day I finally see your name.
But you never did. Nothing happened to me.
There's only so much luck down the well. Sooner or later, pull up that bucket, there's nothing in it.
So, what are we gonna do about Marcano?
Pay him his goddamn money one way or the other.
Lottery gonna be enough to cover it?
The lottery? No. But Sal called a bit ago. Wants you to meet him up the country club. Says he's got something in the works. Square things up between us.
The only black folk allowed in there to help.
Now, they may not like it, but they're not gonna say no to Sal Marcano. He says you get to come in, you get to come in.
Fine. Always did want to see the inside of that place.
You need to do whatever Sal asks, yeah? For all our sakes.
Yes, sir.